Hello, I'm Communications Director Walter Gottlieb, and with me today is Morris Pearl, the Chairman of the Board of Patriotic Millionaires. How are you doing, Morris?
Great to be on your show, Walter. Thank you.
Thanks for joining us. We're going to talk about scrapping the cap on the Social Security payroll tax, but first, I want to ask you, just tell us a little bit more about Patriotic Millionaires and what you do.
Well, sure. Our group was created during the early years of the Obama administration to urge then President Obama to let the Bush tax cuts just for the top bracket expire, as they were over 10 years. And he kind of compromised the Republicans, let it go for another 2 years and got some more benefits for unemployment insurance. But then they realized we were actually helping them do what they wanted to do anyway. And he had us stand on the podium with him when he gave his famous Buffett rule speech on tax day the next year. And since then, over the course of 14 years now, I guess, the group has expanded. We now have hundreds of members from around the country. And basically, we're helping those members, the Patriotic Millionaires, speak out and explain to people that we don't want a country with just a few rich people and lots of people who are struggling to get by. We want a country filled with everyone who makes enough money to participate in our society. And that's what we're working on.
And your organization has been lobbying for years to scrap the cap on Social Security payroll taxes so that the wealthy would pay their fair share. Why have you been at it for so long? And why do you support scrapping the cap?
Sure. I mean, we believe it's just not good policy and it's not fair that we have people who earn more paying lower tax rates as a percentage of their income than people who earn less and are actually having to work for a living. Somebody like me, you know, I'm an investor. I make money from my investments. I haven't worked for, I don't know, 10 years now, 9 years, I guess. And I pay a far lower tax rate than people who actually work for a living. And there's no reason for that. That makes inequality get worse. That means people who are already rich are getting richer and richer and richer. And people who actually have to work for a living are not getting ahead and are struggling to get by. And that's causing our country to lose out on a lot. That's causing social unrest. That's causing people to give up. And that's bad for our society. And that's why we're trying to do something about it.
So you would be hit hard in the pocketbook by this. Maybe hard's the wrong word, but you would be hit if they adjust the cap, then you're going to be paying more every year in Social Security payroll taxes. Why is that okay with you?
Well, it's fine with me if I pay more taxes, because not because I'm altruistic. I'm actually just as greedy as the next guy. What I want, though, is a nation for my children and now my granddaughter to grow up in, where they have the kind of opportunities that I had. Whether I make a little bit more money or a little bit less money next year is less important than looking over the next decades about what kind of country my family is going to grow up in. And I'm trying to do something about that for them.
Thank you. That's a great answer. So along those same lines, conservatives who oppose scrapping the cap will say, we don't want to tax job creators and the investor class anymore, because that will hurt the economy, eventually hurt working people. Why is that a false argument?
Well, they do say that. But if you want to help working people, let me tell you a secret. You can send more money to working people. If you want to help working people, sending more money to rich people like me is not the most direct way to do that. And people like me do not create jobs for anyone. Well, I kind of created a few jobs for the people in the nonprofit that I run. But other than that, you know, I own stock, for instance, in Apple, hundreds of thousands of dollars worth. I make a lot of money. But I did not create a single job for all those people that are working, building iPhones and computers and working in the Apple stores and all those things. Those jobs are created because millions of people want to buy those things. And so my investment in Apple will do better if more people can afford to buy iPhones, not if investors like me pay lower taxes. That's not going to help at all. It's just the idea that somehow rich people create jobs, it's not even true.
So for you, it's a economic and a moral argument. You seem to feel it's the right thing to do in principle and that it would benefit the entire economy and everybody.
Yes, I really do believe okay. that.
And so if I can just finish by talking about Social Security again. So the conservatives don't seem to be willing to bring more revenue into the system. So the alternative for keeping Social Security solvent is to cut benefits. Where does Patriotic Millionaires stand on the question of cutting senior Social Security benefits, either for now or future seniors?
Well, that's a bad idea. People get Social Security benefits. A lot of them need that money to live on. Giving those people less money is not a good idea. That means they'll have less money to spend on paying their iPhone bills, paying their rent, paying their mortgage payments, paying whatever it is they pay. People who are surviving on Social Security need those checks every month because some of them are living paycheck to paycheck. And so that is going to cause a negative ripple effect through the economy. That this trickle down thing, it's just not true. But the trickle up thing is. People like me get rich because money trickles up dollar by dollar from people who pay their bills on time every month. And taking away money from them, that is what is going to indirectly hurt people like me and everyone else too.
And we do hear from people out in the country who are on Social Security that even with Social Security benefits, they have to struggle to pay groceries and rent. So I think what you say is very true. Anyway, Morris Pearl, thank you so much for joining us in sharing this unique perspective. And so good luck with everything you and Patriotic Millionaires are doing. And thanks for being with us.
Thank you. Great to be on your show.